Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My name is Abdul Hakeem Soomro, Associate Professor of Physics, working at Government Girls Degree College, Sakrand, District Shahid Bhai Nazirabad. I discuss the topic from the chapter number 6 of class first year science. The main topic of the chapter number 6 is gravitation. First of all, I discuss about the gravitation and gravity. What is the difference in between these two quantities? What is the gravitation and what is the gravity? So first of all, the gravitation. The definition of the gravitation is every body in the universe attracts every other body with a force is called gravitation. It is clear from this figure, there are the two objects having the masses m1 and other having the mass m2. They are placed near to each other. The mass m1 exerts the force on the M2, and as a reaction force, the M2 will also exert a force, same force on the M1 object. The gravitation means that it is a force of attraction between two bodies in the universe. It is also the one definition of the gravitation. It is not the two bodies which are placed on the surface of Earth, but it also explains the attraction between the planets in the universe, just like our Earth and Sun, our Earth and Moon. So these are the examples of the gravitation. After gravitation, this is the gravity. You also know about the gravity. Gravity means the force with which Earth attracts the body is called gravity. From this figure, if we throw the ball from some height, then what will happen? The ball will be coming down towards the surface of Earth because our Earth attracts this ball with a force. This force is called gravity. So there is a gravity acting on the ball through which this ball lands down on the surface of the Earth. The gravity, in other words, it means that this is the force of attraction between the Earth and the object or body. Third quantity was also the weight, which also discussed in this chapter. What is the weight? The force of attraction between the body and Earth is known as the weight. It is represented by the capital W. Its units of the measurement are Newton, dyne and pound. Newton, it is the unit of the weight in the SI system, and the dyne is also the unit of the weight in the CGI system, whereas the pound, it is the unit of the force or weight in the third system of the measurement of units, that is known as the British Engineering System, which is also referred as BE system, or it is also called the FPA system. What is the FPS? F stand for the foot, P stand for the pound, and S stand for the second. So the British Engineering System always called the FPA system. The formula of the weight is W equal to mg, where W is the weight of the body, m is the mass of the object or body, and g is the force of gravity on the object or body. This figure, an apple lying on the balance. The weight of the apple will be vertically downward direction, just like this figure, W equal to mg, which is vertically downward to the center of the earth. From this figure, if we have the mass of the apple, then you can easily calculate the weight of the apple. For example, the mass of apple is 100 grams, then the value of the g, because gram is the unit of the mass in CGI system, but in this CGI system the value of the g is 981 centimeter per second square. So when we multiply these two values, then we will get the weight of the apple. This is the topic which of the 6.1 topic of the chapter number 6 called Newton's Law of Universal Gravitation. Newton studied about the gravitational force between two bodies and established a law after a number of the experiments, which is called Newton's Law of Gravitation. According to the this Newton's Law of Universal Gravitation, it is simply called the Newton's Law of Gravitation. This Newton's Law of Gravitation states that everybody in the universe attracts every other body with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them, and directed along the line joining their centers. this law having the two parts. First of all, the force of attraction between the two objects is directly proportional to the product of their masses. And second part of this law states that the force of attraction in between two objects is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. The explanation of the Newton's law of gravitation considered two bodies, A and B, having masses MA and MB respectively. Let RBA, R means the distance among the two objects, and BA means the distance between the A and B objects. So RBA is also called the distance between the A and B body. Now from this figure, we take the two objects A and B. A body have the mass MA and the B object having the mass MB. They are placed near to each other and they exert the force of attraction with each in between these two objects. They are also exert the force of attraction between them. The force of attraction in this figure, you can see that if due to the A body, if due to the B body, but the same force will be acting on the both objects. If A body exert the force on the B body, that is the F, it is called action force. Then as a reaction force, the MB body also exert the same quantity of force on the A body, that will be also the F. And this is the distance among these two bodies, RBA. So this is the figure. After that, according to this statement of the Newton's law of gravitation, the first part I have already explained in the theoretical way, but I here explain this first part of the statement in the mathematical way. The force in between the A and B bodies varies directly with the product of MA and MB, means the mass of the A and mass of the B. For example, this equation is the number one equation. After that, the second part of this statement of the law of universal gravitation is that the force between these two bodies is inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. If A, it is the force between the A and B objects, varies inversely with the distance square between these two bodies A and B. This is the equation number second. Now we get the mathematical expression for the Newton's law of universal gravitation by comparing equation 1 and 2. Then when we combine these two, equation 1 and 2, we have the FAB varies AMB upon RBA square. This is the comparing of the both equation, equation 1 and equation number 2. Or we can write this equation due to the constant given for the proportionality. If AB is equal to the G MA MB upon RBA square, where G is the gravitational constant. It is also called proportionality for the varies. It is the constant for proportionality. So we remove the this proportionality and here write the equal, then we write the gravitational constant. This is the capital G, and this then we get the equation number 3. This equation number 3 is the mathematical form of the Newton's law of gravitation, where FAB indicates the gravitational force between the A and B body, G is the gravitational constant, MA is the mass of the body, MB is the mass of the B body upon RBA square. This is the distance square between the B and A objects. This is the equation number 3. As I know, the G will be found by using the experiment which was performed by the Cavendish. By performing the Cavendish experiment to determination of the value of the G, and Cavendish also find the value of the G gravitational constant as 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kilogram square. This value of the capital G means the gravitational constant is the in the SI system. So if you want to calculate the value of the G in CG system, then we have the 6.67 into 10 power minus 8 9 per centimeter square per gram square. The value of the G remains same for all bodies in the universe. It is constant value. Value will be the same for the all bodies in the universe. As the value of the G is very very small, so we cannot feel the force of attraction between the bodies around us. It is the negligible value of the force, nearly equal to the zero, so we cannot feel the this force of attraction among the bodies. My new topic is the mass of the earth. How we calculate the mass of earth? It will be determined by using the Newton's law of gravitation. You see this figure, this big circle, it shows the figure of the earth, and the small sphere, which is the body lying on the surface of the earth. It is a very very small body, just like a table placed on the ground, or we are sitting on the surface of the earth. In this figure, this O, it is the center of the earth, it is the origin of the earth. From origin of earth to the surface of earth, it shows the radius of the earth. It is also the constant property, constant value of the radius of the earth. And ME, it shows the mass of the earth, which we determine by using the Newton's law of gravitation. And this M without E, it is the mass of the body placed on the surface of the earth. For example, a body M is lying on the surface of the earth. Let the mass of the earth is ME and the radius of the earth is RE. According to the Newton's law of gravitation, the force of attraction between the bodies and the earth is given by F equal to the G M M E upon R E square. This is the equation number 1, which explains the mathematical form of the Newton's law of gravitation. But from Newton's second law, the force with which Earth attracts the mass towards its center is called weight. I have already explained the weight in the previous topic. Hence, because the weight also the gravitational force, and F will be equal to the W, means the weight, it is the symbol of the weight, AW, which is equal to the MG, where M capital is the mass of the object lying on the surface of the earth, and G is the acceleration due to gravity. Now we put this value of the weight, means the gravitational force, which is the F, in above equation 1, then F will be equal to the mg, equal to the, on other side, which is the same values, g m m e upon r e square. By cross multiplication, we have G M M E equal to the M G R E square. We get this by cross multiplication. In this figure, in this equation, the M, which is the mass of the body, on other side, is also the M, which is also the mass of the object lying on the surface. They will be cancelled. After that, we have the G M E equal to the G R E square. But we here calculate the value of the mass of the earth. So this mass of earth will be equal to the G R E square upon this G, upon G capital. This equation number 2 is the equation or formula to determine the value of the mass of our earth. In this equation number 2, when we put these values, because you can see that all the, on the right hand side, the all terms are the constant, where G, its value is 9.8 meter per second square. It is also the constant value. And the G is also equal to the 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kilogram square. And Re, which is called the radius of the earth, it is also the constant value, 6.38 × 10⁶ meter. We put these values in equation 2. We have, on substitution, we have this equation, 9.8 × 6.38 × 10⁶, but this is the whole square. This value will be squared upon the value of the G, capital G. This is called the gravitational constant, which is equal to the 6.67 × 10⁻¹¹. On solving these values, then we will get the mass of Earth as 5.98 × 10⁴ kg. On rounding off, the 5.98 will be on rounding off the 6. So this mass of Earth will be equal to the 6 × 10⁴ kg. And after that, my new topic is average density of the Earth. The density is defined as mass per unit volume. We know that our Earth is a sphere. So let ME be the mass of the Earth and VE, VE means the volume of the Earth, be the volume of the Earth, assuming that the Earth is uniform sphere of the volume. Hence, density according to this definition, mass per unit volume. So mathematically we can write the rho. Rho, this is the Greek letter and this is called the density. It is used for the density of any kind of the sphere. So I have already called that, said that our Earth is a sphere. So it also having the some volume, radius. So density will be equal to the mass of Earth upon volume of the Earth. It will be mathematically written as the density equal to the ME upon VE. ME means the mass of Earth, VE means the volume of the Earth. This is the equation number 1. So first of all, we calculate the value of volume of the Earth. We also calculate the value of the mass of Earth in previous topic, that was the 6 × 10⁴ kg. But we not knowing about the volume of the Earth. So first of all, we calculate the volume of the Earth by using this formula, 4/3 πre³. Then rho will be equal to the ME upon 4/3 πre³. On simplification, we have the 3 ME upon 4πre³. This is the equation number 3. Now we put the value of the radius of Earth and the mass of Earth in equation number 2. Mass of Earth, 6 × 10⁴ kg. Re, radius of Earth, which is 6.38 × 10⁶ meter, and pi, it is the constant value 3.14. Put these values in the equation number 2, then we have this equation. Rho equal to the 3 × this is the value of the mass of Earth, this is the 4 figure, and this is the value of the pi, and this is the value of the radius of Earth and cubed. On solution, solving this equation, we have the, after solution, we have the value of the density of Earth will be 5.52 × 10³ kg per meter Q. Thank you.